My name is Mariska.
My name is Stephanie LaRosslier.
My name is Jean-Joseph Saint, or JJ.
Ernest and Juma and Navy.
My name is Ben Werhauser, and I'm from Tacoma, Washington.
Hey, I'm Bridget Kelly, and I'm from New York City.
I am from the U.S. Virgin Islands originally, but I live in Chicago.
I'm from Kaduna, Nigeria. I currently live in Brooklyn, New York.
I'm from New York, but I am of Haitian descent. I'm actually first-generation American. So yeah, grew up in New York City, but I'm very much Haitian.
Originally from Haiti. I grew up in Florida, but I travel a lot. So where am I from? I'm from everywhere.
I've also done my ancestry DNA, my 23andMe, and according to that, I'm 40% Nigerian. So I said, I'm coming home.
So what did I consider before I decided to travel to Africa?
I had the same preconceived notions that probably everybody else in America has, which is...
How different would it be from my hometown?
I thought a lot about, you know,
the likelihood of me getting kidnapped for ransom, possibly killed, was pretty high.
You know, we went to a market down in Lagos, and I mean, it did feel like we were the Spice Girls and we just arrived in town, but the hustle was different. Like, it was like a hustle of love. Like, these people were just trying to make a living. You know, we're all out here hustling. Every single one of us is hustling on a different level.
Yes!
And I honestly thought it was one of the most beautiful places I've ever been.
That it was going to be hot. I thought that it was a place that was probably a little less developed than what I'm usually used to when I travel.
My coworkers were feeling unrest because they were saying someone got kidnapped in Uganda and you're going, and I'm like, that's a totally different country.
And I thought that it might be a place where not necessarily people were trying to take advantage of me, but where I would have to be on my toes to make sure that I wasn't a victim to anybody who was trying to scam me or take advantage of me.
You know, because my family's from essentially a third world country, and you know, one of the shitholes, which we're in another shithole right now, but it looks so beautiful, another shithole country, which is Haiti, and Nigeria was included in that as well. I'm very familiar with the way that this culture is. I'm very familiar with the way that, you know, the people are, with what to expect. So,
to be honest about the fact that this area, Nigeria and the surrounding countries, are an area where my ancestors were taken from before I came here. And so it's a place that I've always wanted to come back to.
But growing up in New York City, obviously I'm exposed to so many different cultures and so many different aspects of culture, whether it's music, it's art, it's food. I was also really excited to experience, you know, something entirely different than anything else I've ever seen in the world.
The diaspora seems to be coming together and finding a way back to its African roots. And how has that impacted me?
I think it's a good thing.
I think it's amazing, honestly.
Obviously, history tells us that all life stems from this continent.
I am one of those people who wants to come back and find those roots, so I guess it's impacted me very directly.
To be honest, it is a beautiful thing. For many years, I mean, since I moved to the U.S., that kind of has been my one job, to connect people, make Africa, you know, a destination where people feel like they can go to, they can travel to.
having traveled and seen a lot of Nigeria, actually. My first trip, I went to Abuja and then took a road trip down to Makurdi and visited a bunch of different townships in between. And this trip, really getting a chance to spend a lot of time with people in Lagos and meet people from different walks of life, from different career paths.
The first time I stepped foot on the continent was about 6 years ago, and I went to Tanzania at the time. And I remember a friend of mine actually saying to me, "Why would you want to go to Africa?" And this is a black male, African American. And I was like, "What do you mean?" And he's like, "Africa's poor, it's dirty, the people are hungry." And I was just like, "Are you kidding me? Like, you clearly, like, your world, like, you live in this microcosm, which is whatever, New York City or whatever it was, or America, and you have no concept of the fact that there are riches outside of America."
Before I came here, I was always thinking about what I was listening to, what I was wearing, and trying to, like, learn more about what was going on in parts of West Africa. And then that grew into a desire to actually want to come here to not only replicate in the U.S. things that I thought were going to be, that I thought were popular in Africa, but to literally just come back here and experience it.
And to see that coming to light, you know, different countries, Ghana, you know, Kenya we did last year, you know, obviously South Africa, Rwanda, you know, a lot of places getting a lot of shine. To be honest, it's kind of surreal, but you know, I mean, it's a beautiful thing.
Now with people actually taking the time to travel, to try to get back to their roots, to spend time on the continent, you know, to explore, I think it's amazing. It's us finding, you know, our power again. Us realizing that, you know what, you can have a country of black people that are, you know, everything from the president to, you know, to the guy working in the factory. And it can be an economy that does well. It can be a society that does well. Like, we don't necessarily have to live in their world.
I come from a country where I left and I studied abroad, had masters in all kinds of education levels, and it would have been an easy thing not to come back home, and I had decided to do so. And I encourage diasporas to move back to their hometown because it is the best way to actually form development and new thinking and forward thinking.
I think it's safe to say that this is really the birthplace of culture. This is the birthplace of life, of agriculture, of the hustler. I mean, if we're gonna be honest, you know, I have never seen so many resilient, self-sufficient people.
This one I gotta do with the job, da. Me, I no get time, I did that, ba da.
Yes, we're smack in the middle of the trip, what do I think of Lagos? I think it's beautiful.
I don't know if my ancestors came from Lagos, but I do feel like I'm home.
I think that it's beautiful. There are lots of beautiful, you know, cityscapes, buildings, beaches, restaurants, nightlife here. There are lots of beautiful spaces that I think the average person, or maybe just me, didn't necessarily expect when I was coming over to Lagos.
Except for the airport. Airport needs some work. I, you know what, you should, like, honestly, Haiti should not have a better airport. That's all I gotta say, because we are so far behind.
I think that Lagos is vibrant.
We've had a wonderful balance of seeing some really high-level fashion and art and creative stuff, and that's been special. And then also, you know, you're seeing people that clearly are working hard to get by and survive, and so I think seeing those two together is always a little bit difficult and has some tension, but I'm grateful for that tension and want to step into it.
It is hot. I think that I have already gotten a pretty good tan. I'm working on my melanin. I'm getting nice and brown back to where it should be.
I feel like I melt with the people here. Skin color, looks, mannerisms, speech, all of it. I feel I could have been on a street in Haiti or I can be in Lagos.
It's a city. It's a vibrant city. And I think a lot of times people tend to think of a lot of places in Africa as going to be just some underdeveloped, dry, you know, sad place. But it's happy and it's colorful and it's beautiful and it's just a full grown bustle. Giddy Fest! I'm so pumped to be here for Giddy Fest. I'm thinking that I'm going to learn a bunch of new dances, or at least see a bunch of new dances that I would like to learn, but probably I'm not coordinated enough to accomplish.
I've wanted to attend Giddy Fest for, the fifth year now? But there's always a conflict with one of the events that I put up in New York. And so, you know, I think we even deliberately planned our event so it wouldn't conflict this year with Giddy Fest, because, you know, there was no way I was missing it.
Or I'm expecting Giddy Fest to be an eye-opener to new music genres, to a new sound, to something different than the pop culture that was printed onto me.
I think the idea of a festival that brings together, you know, different artists from around the continent, to Lagos, is spectacular. I'm particularly looking forward to, you know, some of the artists. I know Patoran King, you know, is amazing. Niniola, Zlatan, god damn it.
I've been to a number of festivals all over the world, Japan, Sweden, Switzerland, Germany, Australia, New Zealand, you name it. There's nothing like coming to a place that is so rich in musical culture and musical history.
I am very excited because I'm involved in the music industry back home, and this festival to me is something new and exciting.
There's something about live music that does something to people, and especially people of African descent. Like, we, you know, we're hungry, the food comes, we start dancing, we start singing. Like, it's part of our culture, it's part of who we are, and I'm just looking forward to being a part of that.
Live music has always, I've always thought our artists, are one of our bigger exports to the world, and so it's amazing to get people come experience them in their hometown, you know, sort of see how loved and appreciated they are on their home turf. I think it's important for people from the outside to actually experience that. And you know, I'm not a big festival guy, but this is one festival I'm looking forward to.
Giddy Fest is the perfect opportunity and platform to number one, discover new artists that I am excited about listening to and being able to tell all my friends about back home. And number two, get to see some of the artists that I know and have come to love after having come here a few years ago and keeping tabs and keeping in contact with their progress and their success. And if I get the opportunity to come back, fingers crossed, and perform next year, we'll put that in the universe.
Would I tell people to come for an experience like this? Absolutely. We have had so much fun, and I definitely would invite my friends. I actually did invite quite a few of them, and now that they're looking at my Insta stories, I'm getting the, oh my gosh, I should have come. you know, going, I've been to lots of music festivals, I've been to music festivals in the States, I've been to them in Europe. This is my first time coming to one in Africa, but the interesting thing about this one and what kind of sets it apart is that it's a music festival, and that's wonderful, and that unifies people all over. Everybody knows you want to come to learn new music and learn new dances and see new artists, but you get to experience that while also experiencing this part of the world that you never get to hear about, see about in the way that you hear and see about it while you're here.
Ready? Fire the hole!
Anything to people in the diaspora, either in America, South America, about wanting to come home, or fears about coming home, just come. What is there to be scared about? This is where we came from. And I've said it to people here since I came, but if you think about it, so much history of the world has been shaped by people leaving the places that we go to visit now, the popular tourist destinations in Europe. They left there to come here and to take things back from here because it's great. So why not come to this place to see what everybody else wanted to come and take from?
Here she be crying, here she be crying, give thanks and praise to the Lord, and I will feel alright.
So I've been already, you guys.
If you can be at your house, if you can live and be in your neighborhood, you can live and be in Lagos.
Yeah, I think hesitation and fears can be natural, but at some point it's just good to go for it and give things a try.
But for enjoyment, man, you want to live your life in fear or you want to enjoy your damn life?
About, you know, crime in any part of the world. And if you probably talk to most people about those stories that you hear in most other places, as well as this one, if they live there, they'll tell you they're overblown, right?
Especially in this day and age. Can't believe everything that you hear, and you definitely can't believe everything that you don't see.
It's all perceptions, and most of the time, other people are influencing those perceptions.
So I will say, do your research. get a group of people together, find your tribe, find people that love to travel, find people that love to expand their horizons, to expand their minds, to enrich their lives, and also who want to give back to a culture that has continued from the beginning of time to contribute to everything that we are about.
I think if you're willing to skydive, you know, and do some of the other shit that will actually kill you, and take drugs, take marijuana, Molly, shit, I think Lagos is the least of your problems.
But like every destination you go to, you research it, you find out where you want to go, find out where you want to be, where it's safe for you to be and comfortable, and then you just come along home. There's nothing to be afraid of at all.
Embrace your roots. We are the beginning and the end. We are a civilization that was here before any other, and don't let anyone take that away.
Come and have your own experience and see it for yourself. You feel comfortable. There's nothing to fear.
So yeah, get over here, feel it, see it, touch the soil. It's definitely gonna help you get a better perspective on your life and I think, you know, who you are.
But that's a story that people have painted for 40, 50 years, you know? And so, you know, it's not gonna be undone in a second. So, you know, I understand your fear, but you're ridiculous. You need to come.
Okay.